Hello, I'm Grigory Fedorishin, the CEO of NLMK Group. Today our company reported its financial results for the fourth quarter and full year 2019. As you know, last year was challenging for the industry. Its second half saw prices falling below the cycle average. The dive was deep. We estimate that 80% of global HRC production was loss-making. The margins in the sector were further pressured by increasing prices for raw materials. For NLMK, the low phase of the market happened to overlap with major maintenance works at our blast furnace and steelmaking operations at Lipetsk site. This enabled us to minimize the impact of the repairs on the group's financial performance. As you recall, these repairs, combined with other projects, will deliver an additional 1 million tons of steel output for NLMK starting from 2021. However, last year they led to 3% year-on-year reduction in our sales volumes. In addition to lower steel output, the another major factor to drive down the profitability was the decline in global prices for steel products. The group's capex totaled $1.1 billion in 2019, in line with our guidance. NLMK Group revenue in 2019 decreased by 12% year-on-year. EBITDA was $2.6 billion, which is 29% lower than the previous year. Our EBITDA margin was 24%. Large-scale maintenance projects at Lipetsk site and the active phase of implementation of Strategy 2022 investment program were the key factors behind capex growth year-on-year. As a result, and supported by higher dividend payout in line with NLMK's new dividend policy adopted in March last year, the group's net debt to EBITDA ratio reached 0.7, which is below the long-term target of 1.0. Successful measures were taken to release working capital. This increased our free cash flow in the fourth quarter of last year by 36% to $338 million. NLMK's management recommended to the board of directors to pay out fourth quarter dividends in the amount of $500 million. Total dividend amount for 2019 is equivalent to 120% of our free cash flow. The capex amount for the calculation of dividends was normalized as per our dividend policy. Moving on to the forecast for the first quarter of 2020, we expect steel production at NLMK Lipetsk to increase to the first quarter 2019 level, following the completion of the first phase of major repairs at blast furnace and steelmaking operations. Let me now touch upon Strategy 2022 execution. The structural effect on 2019 financial performance exceeded $200 million per annum. Operational efficiency programs earned an effect of $170 million relative to 2018 cost base, including the gains from an NLMK Quebec restructuring. The larger part of the effects was captured at Russia Flat Products and the mining segment. EBITDA gains from the investment program totaled $41 million, mostly driven by projects aimed at growing production at Stolinsky mine. As you can see, the bulk of the gains came from zero capex operational efficiency projects. EBITDA gains from the investment program will be captured further down the strategic cycle. In Q4 last year, we completed a large-scale revamp of blast furnace number 6 and steelmaking shop number 2 at NLMK Lipetsk. In addition to improved productivity, we were able to reduce our environmental footprint at these production units. The revamp of steelmaking shops will also enable us to utilize BOF gases for power generation at the new cogeneration plant. We have already signed contracts for the supplying of the main equipment and design of the plant is in progress. Other development projects have also entered the active phase. We will talk about Strategy 22 execution and our plans for 2020 in more details at the upcoming Capital Markets Day that will be held in London on March 24th. We will be very glad to welcome you there. Thank you and see you soon.